minute, bud. Well, here's my typical disclaimer. If you're offended by cursing or you know, bad words, move the fuck on about right now. Anyway, something occurred to me yesterday. You know, Christmas is, which, you know, some 5 months away, something like that, but it comes on me like that. And I've been making videos about, you know, guns, gun rights, blah, 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 what you should do, blah, blah, blah. So it occurred to me, you got Christmas coming. And I had said on the previous video how a lot of gun shops will do layaways and stuff like that. Well, think about this idea. Especially you guys, because God only knows, we don't know, we have really no clue what to buy a woman. And a lot of women have no clue what in the world to buy their men. You know, they're trying to do the best they can, but a lot of times it doesn't work out really well. But how about buying your significant other a gun? You ain't got to break the bank. I know a couple places. Bud's Gun Shop is a good one. Budsguns.com. They do layaway, like 90-day layaway. And there's a couple of pistols on there made by High Point. They've been talked bad about. Everybody talks bad about High Point because they're so cheap. You can literally get a 40 caliber in your hand for right at $200. But everybody says, well, you know, you get them because they're cheap. They're crap. No, they aren't. Everybody says that until they shoot one. And then everybody after that says, God, this thing is great for the money. Plus, if somebody steals it, you ain't crying because somebody just stole a, you know, $600 pistol. So that's something to think about. But if you get someone a gun instead of trying to figure out what else you're going to get them, after that, it's endless. The stocking stuffers. You know, there's a box of shells. You can go for concealed weapons permit. You can sign your sign them up for that. Put it in a birthday card. I mean, it's endless. Once you, the accessories that you have the options of getting. But once you do that, you have all these things you can buy. The gun cleaning kit. You know, you have a for another year or two, or at least. You can buy accessories as gifts. And if you're not sure what to get them, you can always get them a gift card. Like Dick's Sporting Goods, Sports Town, all them things. You buy them a gift card, and even if they don't buy anything for the gun, there's always tennis shoes in there. There's all kinds of stuff. So it helps us guys figure out what to get the girls. It's just a thought. And you got 5 months to figure out what you want to do. I suggest if a man is buying a woman a gun, get a subcompact. It'll fit their hand a lot better. It won't feel like a bazooka in their hand. I'm only about 5'9", so that puts me in a compact. A big full size doesn't feel right in my hand as I change the grips out. So for a guy my size, you know, give or take, a compact works best. Guys over 6 foot, full size, typically. That's a little thing, you know. A real popular round with law enforcement, and I think the military is going to it if they haven't already gone to it. It's 40 caliber. That's a real popular round. Most 40 calibers will shoot 357 too. Excuse me. I don't care for a revolver that much, although they do have a tendency to not fail at all. But if you keep your gun clean, you take care of it, that automatic, and you put the right shells in it. You can buy the best gun in the world, buy cheap shells, and you might have problems with it. So if you're going to buy a good gun, buy good shells. You don't have to buy the highest price shell, but don't buy the cheapest ones. That's something else to think about. But one thing about it, a family that shoots together, they pretty much stay together. They have more in common. You know, and it's a lot cheaper, a whole hell of a lot cheaper than owning a Harley. Of course, I got one. I know how much money you can put in one. A boat. I mean, how much money are you going to spend filling that daggum thing up? You know? Whole lot cheaper than going to a bar. I mean, you know, you can go to a bar and easily spend $100, $150. And you ain't got nothing to show for it but a headache and some itching and burning the next day. At least that's what they tell me. So it's just a thought. that plus you're helping to protect a person you love. And a good thing that I've learned is, you know, you talk to your wife, and it's in May, and she's got her gun, and she's going to drive up 100 miles somewhere to see one of her friends. You don't say, honey, you got your gun too, do you? Because then you start telling it. If you keep saying that, you sound kind of fanatical. So what you do is you name that gun. Call it Betsy, Daisy, whatever you want to. You and Daisy heading out, right? It's a hint, but you don't sound like a gun fanatic. You get the idea. Anyway, just some thoughts. It's always a good gift. Always a good gift idea, and it makes it easier for you to figure out what to get them next time. Anyway, have a good day. Thanks for listening.